Welcome back. In this lesson, we're going to create an Amazon VPC with a couple of subnets using the AWS CLI. So before you start this, you must have done the previous lesson and configured your command line interface with credentials. And of course, you must have installed the AWS CLI, which we actually did back at the beginning of the course. So also, you'll need this file to be open. So this is a file which you'll find in your course download, AWS CLI. Create vpc-cli.sh. So open this file, and as you go through this file, you'll find that you need to update some values. So you'll run a command, we'll get some output, and then you'll need to record the information. So what I suggest you do is have this file open, and as you go through, just replace the values that you see I have in here. So for example, we're going to need to replace the VPC ID in several places. So just record it into the file, and then that's an easy way to keep track of this information when you need it in subsequent commands. So this is what we're going to do. The first section is to create a VPC. There's a bunch of commands here. What we're going to do is create VPC, create subnets, create an internet gateway, attach it. We're going to create a route table and then an entry that points to the internet gateway. We're then going to associate the route table with a subnet. We'll modify the route table to supply public IPs to instances automatically. And then in the next lesson, we're going to move on and actually launch an instance into the subnet for testing. And at the very end, we've got some commands to clean up. So let's come back up to the top. And what we want to do is we're going to create our VPC. Now, I've chosen the CIDR block 10.10.0.0/16. I don't think that's going to conflict with anything else we've done in this course. So we don't need to change any values here. Unless you've already got a VPC with this CIDR block, then just change the CIDR block. So I'm going to copy that to my clipboard, come back, paste that in, and we need to record the VPC ID. So I'm going to copy this VPC ID, come back, and then in the next command here, we update the VPC ID. And you're going to see there's two commands here, because what we're doing is we're creating subnets. And you can leave these CIDR, as long as you didn't change the overall CIDR block, then the CIDR block for the subnet can remain as this. So it's 10.10.1.0 with a 24-bit mask and 10.10.2.0 with a 24-bit mask. So what we're going to do is run each of these commands. So I'll paste that one in and I've created a subnet. Come back, grab the next one, put that in my clipboard, paste that in, and we've got a bit of a typo there. So I've got two Vs on my VPC ID. So let me just go back, clean that up, hit enter. And there we go, we've got our second subnet as well. And it tells us a bit of information. It records the available IP addresses, the availability zone, and clearly you can see that the state is available. Now, map public IP on launch is false. That's why we need to go back and change that later on. So let's come back out. I'm just going to correct this here. The next thing we're going to do is create the internet gateway. We don't need to modify anything for this command. Just paste it in. And that creates an internet gateway. Now, the internet gateway is not attached to a VPC at this stage. So what we need to do now is attach the internet gateway. Now, for this, we need to copy the VPC ID, and we need the internet gateway ID. Now, I rushed ahead a bit there, and I didn't record my internet gateway ID. So let's head over to the console, and I'll find it there. So in the console, making sure I'm in the correct region that I'm actually creating this, which is my default region, by the way. So because I'm not specifying a region in the CLI commands, it's going to the default region, which is specified when I configured my CLI, which for me is Sydney. So let's just go up to internet gateways, and I can see it's this internet gateway here because it's detached. So I just copy that ID. Let's paste that back in and copy this command, and we should be able to attach our internet gateway. So that's done. So if I come back to the console here now and just refresh, there we go. We've got an attached internet gateway. We're now going to create a custom route table. Again, make sure you've updated your VPC ID. So I'm going to copy it from here, paste it in, and create the route table. Created the route table, and we're going to need to copy the route table ID. So I'm just going to copy that, come back down. I can put this in here. So what we're doing now is we're going to create a route in this route table. So we need the route table ID. The rest is the same except for the gateway ID. So we need the internet gateway ID, which we recorded a little bit further back here. So I'm going to copy the internet gateway ID, paste that in. And so this is going to create a route using the internet gateway for 0000/0, which, as you know, means everything that doesn't have a more specific route in the route table. So that's going to route traffic out to the internet. So let's just hit the enter here, and that's done. So if we come back to the console, it's nice to just keep tabs on what we're doing. We should find that we've now got a new route table. So that will be this one here. If I click on routes, you can see that we have a route to the internet gateway. And of course, it has a local route as well for the CIDR block for the VPC. Now, we can also check on the command line. So here, we've got this command line option. Again, of course, don't forget to update your route table ID. Paste that in, and there you go. We can see some information about our route table. So let's come to the next command. What we need to do is retrieve the subnet IDs from earlier on. So what we need here is we're going to need to go back up and grab our VPC ID, and we need to paste that into this section here. So excuse me, straight from the equals. So take it from there, replace that. So we've got the VPC ID. So it should be values equals, and then your VPC ID. And what this will do is it will give us some output, which shows us the IDs for the two subnets that we created earlier. And then we can decide which one we want to be the public subnet. So let's say I want to copy this one here. So I'm going to make the 10.10.1.0 subnet my public subnet. So I come back and I'm going to paste that subnet ID in here. And I need to copy the route table ID again. Copy it from up there. Let's paste it in. Copy the whole command. Come back. And there we go. We've now associated a subnet with the route table. So come back again. And this time we're going to configure the subnet to issue a public IP to EC2 instances. So here we need to modify the subnet ID again. So copy from here, paste it into this command. Let's put that on our clipboard, come back, and there we go. We've now modified our subnet so that it will provide public IP addresses to instances that are launched. So that's it for this lesson. We've done everything I wanted to do now. I don't want to go on too long in one lesson, so I'm going to break this into two lessons. In the next lesson, we're going to launch an instance into a subnet for testing. Now, let's just come back and have a look at what we've done, though, in the console. So we can see that we have our new VPC here with a 10.10.0.0 CIDR block. If we come down to subnets, what you'll see is we've got two subnets. It's these two here, the 10.10.1 and the 10.10.2. If we come down to route tables, we'll see that we have an explicit subnet association to a route table. So we created a custom route table, and that's the one that we've put the internet gateway into. And we can see that we have this internet gateway running. That one is actually attached to our VPC. So that's great. That's how we can actually create a VPC from the command line very easily. And in the next lesson, we're going to launch an EC2 instance and test that everything works correctly.